Gower, are you here?
Sorry, anybody? I was on mute. Yes. Ah, hi, Stefan.
Hi, Dave. How are you?
Very good. Very good. Thank you. I sent a few slides in. Oh, there they are. So if we just skip ahead a couple. I think one is just forward-looking statements. Okay. Let's just forget this. This is the full deck. Sorry, I must have sent you the wrong thing.
No, I didn't get it. That's your presentation that's on your website right now.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I sent you just a couple of slides. So basically, if you just scroll ahead a little bit further, then...
You can also share your screen if you can.
Okay, the next... Let's start with this slide that's the next one up.
This one?
No... Yeah, that one. Yes, we'll start with this. Okay, so the Iberia Belt West project, for those of you who've been following the recent presentations, we were awarded that in the summer, and we are just in the process of getting the drilling permit, which we've been waiting patiently, as have our shareholders, for a much longer time than we expected. As with everything, I guess we're in a COVID world. But I have been informed as of this morning that a letter from the Environment Department in Huelva Province to the Mines Department was sent, and so we should get that imminently. We're going to be pushed up against Christmas, so I would say very likely it'll be January we will start drilling. But just to remind people, the first drilling that we'll be doing will be on this Infanta deposit. It's only been drilled to shallow depths with very high grades, 1.5 to 4% copper, zinc grades of, 10 to plus 20%, and silver grades that are between 100 and 300 grams per ton. Very shallow. It's only been drilled to about 110 meters to date. The program that we laid out, if you look at the last press release, should extend the strike length of this from about 600 meters to more than 1,200. And we'll extend the down dip targeting of this to about 300 meters depth. If you go to the next one, Stefan, keep going. I won't talk more about that. That's really the update. Well, maybe stop here. You could get a sense for what we're drilling. At Infanta, 5.7 meters with 181 grams of silver, 1.3 copper, almost 12 zinc in the upper hole. 5.3 meters of 240 grams per ton silver, almost 3% copper and 24% zinc in the deeper hole. So it's a very high grade deposit at surface. We already have about 40 odd holes into this from the historical work. We will update that and expand it into a 43-101 resource in the first part of next year. Okay, the next one, Stefan. And the other deposit on the property is the Romanero deposit, which is the larger of the two. And we'll also be drilling on this first quarter of next year, we expect. If you just keep going to the next slide, perhaps. Again, we have about 50 drill holes into this deposit as well. It was drilled by RTZ and Asturiana Zinc before that. So it's a 34 million ton deposit, comes to surface. You can kind of see that one line where the along the south edge of the drilling there is where the old trenches were, where it comes to surface and dips off to the north. We're focused on this 11 million tons of high grade, which is within that 34 million tons. And then if you just look at the table again, this is a very gold rich system. You can look at see very good gold values for this type of deposit within the high grade zone. And if you look
that's almost 1 million ounces of gold, or yeah, like 100,000 ounces with 34 million tons historically. That's quite a number.
That is. And that doesn't include, that grade is understated because the early drilling was done by Asturiana de Zinc. So you see those C-named holes, C1, C2, C4. Asturiana didn't even assay for gold. So the average gold grade that's been calculated this basically makes a zero when there's no value. So we will expect to see tonnage increasing on this deposit without even drilling a hole, just by assaying for gold when we go through some of those things. Similarly, when Rio Tinto did their work at that time, gold was just a four-letter word. It was in one of the downturns that Stefan mentioned too. And when they did their composites, they just added lead plus zinc. They didn't actually use gold as part of the calculation. So very straightforward, geologically nice thick deposit. The deepest hole is about 350 meters. The deposit's still 20 meters thick at that depth, and should be very good.
Yeah, and actually, you didn't really acquire this project, but you won a tender, a public tender, and that's like really special because you didn't spend any money on it. You haven't been working on it in the last years. It's a large deposit, as you can see here, 34 million tons, and it has been extensively drilled in the past. So the government, the local governments, they have been looking for mining companies to take it over and take it to the next level. So I believe this is a really great proposition of how you actually acquired this project. Can you tell us a little bit about that and then maybe go over to the Asnal Kollar?
Sure. It was a public tender process. So there's no cash payment to acquire it. It's basically to do the work to develop it. The tender was disputed for a number of years. So we've actually been through a more than a five-year process to acquire the property that involved a legal battle, but it ultimately went to the Supreme Court of Spain. We're in the Pyrite Belt in southern Spain, and the Supreme Court ruled in our favor earlier this year, and there's no further appeals. The government has subsequently awarded it to us. We're in the permitting process for the drilling, which we expect should be imminent. And we'll be drilling very high-grade holes early next year.
And you already have the funds. I saw that you were doing a private placement. You increased it very sharply from $2.5 million to $4.5 million. Why did you increase it? Was the demand so high for this financing?
We were fully subscribed at $4.5 million, Stefan, including the overage. And in fact, had to cut people back at that level. So we're in very good shape financially to really push hard on this project, and also to initiate a more aggressive approach on the next one, which we can talk about now.
Sure, let's do that.
So Asnal Kollar is the other major project in southern Spain that we've been working on. This one has been involved in a criminal case, but it's also concluding. And if you looked at our recent press release, you see that it's been through two rounds of appeal, and we've had five superior court judges in both cases unanimously rule in our favor. This was a past producer, so it is drilled off as a reserve already, high grade, and this tender was put out and approved by all levels of government in Spain, and all parties unanimously voted in favor of doing it. Again, it's an area with very high unemployment and very, very strong support. The community actually lobbied to have this put out and put back into production. So we expect early next year that this should be resolved, and all indications are at this point it will be in our favor. If you scroll down, perhaps to this slide. So this was operated as a large open pit. It's a 70 million ton deposit. Again, what we would be looking at is actually developing an underground mine, much higher grade, about 10% combined lead zinc with 2 to 3 ounces of silver. Essentially ramping from the existing pit. Because it's drilled as a open pit reserve, it was only drilled to about 350 meters depth. The deepest holes that you see, and we're only talking about the central lens here on this map, the deepest holes are still 40 meters thick of massive sulfides. The deposit that looks like it's in the hanging wall is the original Asnal Kollar deposit. It's actually more copper rich, probably almost a 90 million ton deposit. We haven't even looked at that. It's quite a bit lower grade, but given where we think copper is going, that will also become important. The deposit to the left doesn't even have a name. It's just some drill holes, very good grade, very similar to what we see at the Los Frailes deposit, which is the middle one. All of these could be accessed from that underground access. And if you just look at the historical resource below, so that 20 million tons there is Boliden's number, who were the operator. That's pit constrained. When we take the pit constraint off, we come up with a number closer to about 28 million tons. And of course, it's still wide open. So that's really, you know, this is a game-changing type deposit that's already drilled as a reserve and will go straight to feasibility, essentially. A few other things, if you were on the last call that we did, there were some questions about our ownership on our northern properties. I'll just update people and say that the Plaza Norte joint venture, which someone had indicated we had lost. In fact, our permits were renewed at that project as they were at Sierra Alta for three more years. And we are in the process of closing the financing that Stefan mentioned earlier. So great shape. The stock has come off a little bit because of the time it's taking to get the permitting done. But once the permits are in place, and that should be any day now, we'll be permitted for the entire duration of the license at Iberia Belt West, which is about 3 years. So we don't have to go through this process every time we drill. Just a very exciting time after a very long grind.
Absolutely. No, I'm following your company. I'm a shareholder myself, and I really love the prospects. You have a market cap right now of 15 million. It's trading at 16 cents, 85 million shares out. So I think with even only the Paymore, the zinc gold project there, it's great value. It's a large deposit. And if you get this one here as well, next year, I think this will also be another game changer for the company. So thanks very much, David Gower, for being here. And we will be following your company.
Thank you.
Price.